Hey guys, how's it going? It's Anton Jackson. So for this video, I wanted to look at a pretty minor character in the Better Call Saul and Breaking Bad universe, Ken, the stockbroker who crosses paths with both Walter White and Jimmy Mcgill in Breaking Bad and Better Call Saul, respectively. Ken is a character that only appears once in both shows, but has a surprisingly integral role in the development of both of these major characters. We first meet Ken in Breaking Bad in Season 1 in the episode Cancer Man. In Breaking Bad, Walter White first meets Ken when he goes to the Mesa Credit Union to get a cashier's check in order to pay for his oncologist appointment to get a preliminary diagnosis of his lung cancer. Walt first encounters Ken here when he steals Walt's parking spot. This causes Walt to become visibly upset and additionally forces Walt to wait in line behind Ken in the credit union. Ken's actions and dialogue in the scene are meant to stereotypically portray him as a vulgar stockbroker who drives a red BMW and openly boasts about the amount of money he makes. This, of course, is juxtaposed here by the fact that Walt is in need of cancer treatment without the legal financial means to pay for it. Walt becomes so angry and distracted with Ken's behavior that he's unaware of the attendant calling him to say that he's next in line. Later in this episode, Walter encounters Ken again when he's driving and has a coughing fit, which is so violent it causes him to have to pull over his car. Walt then realizes that he's coughing up blood. Again, Walt unintentionally runs into Ken here when he sees his red BMW pull into a gas station with his unforgettable license plate, which reads, "Ken Wins." After going through a large amount of emotional distress in this episode, including having to tell his family that he has lung cancer, and now the fact that he's coughing up blood symbolizing just how sick he is, Walt decides to blow up Ken's car. This is a really powerful and morally ambiguous scene here in Breaking Bad. Walt's actions are clearly illegal and would most certainly warrant his arrest if he was caught. However, at the same time, I would find it surprising if anyone watching this scene for the first time would sympathize with Ken in any way. Walt's precarious health situation, along with the stereotypical caricature of a stockbroker being a self-centered, arrogant, and unsympathetic character, makes the audience sympathize with Walt. This is a huge development in the character of Walter White compared to the man who we were first introduced to in the pilot episode of Breaking Bad, who would be seemingly hard-pressed to pick up a penny off the sidewalk which did not belong to him, let alone blow up another man's car for the sake of his own personal revenge. We see Ken again in Season 2 of Better Call Saul in the episode Switch. At the beginning of Season 2, Jimmy turns down a job with Davis in Maine and decides to quit being a lawyer. When Kim presses him to say why he turned down this great job opportunity, Jimmy proceeds to invite Kim to scam Ken after overhearing him at a bar speaking in the same vulgar manner as he did in front of Walt in Breaking Bad. At the end of the scene, Jimmy and Kim scam Ken into paying for an entire bottle of Saviro Añejo under the false pretense that they will invest $1.4 million of an inheritance with him. The event of scamming Ken really strengthened the relationship bond between Jimmy and Kim and ended up being the genesis of the relationship being taken to the next level, which we saw over the course of Season 2 and Season 3 of Better Call Saul. Ken ends up being collateral damage again here like he was with Walter White in Breaking Bad.
Hey. What is... Is this right?
So interestingly, both Walt and Jimmy, along with Kim, use Ken as a proverbial punching bag in their own personal character development. I find it really interesting here that the writers decided to use the character of Ken this way in both of these shows respectively. It is initially easy for the audience to sympathize with Walt and Jimmy and their actions against Ken in these episodes, as he's portrayed as a narcissistic stockbroker who is only looking out for himself. However, these are characteristics which Walt and Jimmy would eventually assume for themselves over the course of Breaking Breaking Bad. It's truly ironic that both Walt and Jimmy take advantage of a character who is truly unsympathetic, yet by the conclusion of Breaking Bad, both Walt and Jimmy commit numerous actions which overshadow the vulgarity and narcissism of Ken.